OpenAI strikes again, and is anyone surprised? They just launched a brand new model called ChatGPT-4o, and that O stands for omni. And what this means is the model is much more capable of handling all three inputs of audio, visual, and text, and outputting any of those three as well.
The announcement is about me? Well, color me intrigued. Are you about to reveal something about AI?
Yes. It looks like the king is in residence right now. The royal standard flag is flying above Buckingham Palace, which is a signal that the monarch is present.
For all you Marvel fans out there who wish you had access to Jarvis just like Tony Stark, you might have that now. This new model is fast. It offers an average response time of just 320 milliseconds. Compare this to GPT-4, which was 5.4 seconds, and GPT-3.5, which was 2.8 seconds. So the reason they wanted to refine this so much is to make it feel human-like when you're talking or interacting with the model. The real question is, what can this thing do? OpenAI gave us a ton of examples on their website, and today we're gonna go over the ones that I found most interesting. Next to each of the examples, I have additional use cases. And in future videos, I plan to address some of these use cases specifically, so stay tuned for those. But let's go ahead and jump right into the first one.
Hey, my friend and I are learning Spanish, and we're wondering if you could tell us the names of these objects in Spanish.
Hola, por supuesto.
Cool. What are these objects in Spanish?
The objects you're showing are una manzana and un plátano in Spanish. Nice fruit choice.
Cool.
In this first example, you can see just how powerful the audio and video combined with this new model is. You can see that they're just looking around the room, pointing at objects, and it's giving the Spanish translation immediately.
In this form, hello there. I'm here with my son, and I'd love you to tutor him on this math problem, but don't give him the answer. You can ask questions and nudge him in the right direction, but I really want to make sure he understands it himself. And he's here in the room, so you can talk to him directly.
Which side do you think is the hypotenuse?
Remember,
the hypotenuse?
I'm not totally sure. I think it might be this one, but I really am not sure. This side AC?
You're close. Actually, side AC is called the adjacent side to the angle alpha. The hypotenuse is the longest side of a right triangle and is directly opposite the right angle. Can you find which one is the hypotenuse?
Oh, okay, I see. So I think the hypotenuse is this really long side from A to B. Would that be correct?
Exactly. Well done.
Second, with the mobile app already out there and a desktop application coming soon, you can now share your screen and let GPT talk to you to do endless possibilities. For example, you know, in this situation, ChatGPT is tutoring, but you can imagine sharing your screen for any number of other things as well.
Shipping it back would be the best option. Could you please provide the shipping information and process to get a replacement?
Absolutely. I'll email a shipping label and return instructions. Could you provide Joe's email address for me?
Sure. It's joe@example.com.
Awesome. All right. I've just sent the email. Can you check if Joe received it?
Here's an example of allowing GPT-4o to be your customer service agent. So this unlocks a lot of possibility for automation in the workplace.
Hey, ChatGPT.
Hey there, how's it going?
Yeah, it's going really well. I was wondering if you could help me with a coding problem today.
Of course, I'd love to help you out. What's the coding problem you're dealing with?
Okay, I'm gonna share with you some code. One second.
Sure thing, take your time.
Okay, so I just shared some code with you. Could you give me a really brief one-sentence description of what's going on in the code?
This code fetches daily weather data for a specific location and time period, smooths the temperature data using a rolling average, annotates a significant weather event on the resulting plot, and then displays the plot with the average, minimum, and maximum temperatures over the year.
Here's another example of using the desktop app to share code and let ChatGPT see what you're seeing and get things done based on it. In OpenAI's presentation, they really focused on the omni capabilities that come with the new update, but there's a lot of other added capabilities with the model that they didn't really touch on. Coming back to the website, if you go to this exploration of capabilities portion, it shows you all the other things that are able to be done with the update, and these are extremely exciting as well. The first thing is it's able to take text as input and output that well, which is very hard for most image models to do. So you can see that they wanted a robot typewriting the following journal entries, and then they put exactly what they wanted on the typewriter. And you can see the output shows exactly what they wanted. So this is exciting. This is something we couldn't really do before. And another similar example is what they're calling variable binding. So you're able to give the model different things to put together. So variables, you know, putting variables together. And you can see in this example, they wanted the model to create an image with three different blocks with three different letters on them. And it does an amazing job. The next big thing is consistent characters. So this is another thing that with generative AI, we've kind of struggled with. It's gotten a lot better with other applications like Midjourney. But it looks like with the new model, ChatGPT model, it's gonna be pretty easy to do this. In this example, they made a cartoon, so Sally, the male woman, and then they were able to replicate her doing different things. And you can see they're able to make basically a whole storybook based on this character. Moving along with that same example, they have another one here of Geary the robot. So you can see they're having him do different things. Consistently, it's the same character, the same hat, just performing different actions, which is really exciting for things like comic books, coloring books. And you could, it doesn't have to be, you know, a cartoon character. You can make it whatever you want. Another big thing is you're able to upload your own images or images of real people and combine them together, create different variations, use this image in different situations. So this does get a little bit scary, right? Because deep fakes and other things out there. But in this example, they took two images and asked them to be combined into a movie poster. This one didn't turn out so hot, but they had the model redo it. And you've got these two people in a movie poster with the words that they asked for and the facial expressions that they were looking for on the two people. In a similar example, you're able to upload a photo of someone. So we have the same person in this one in their example, and they turned it into a cartoon character. So as you can imagine, so many use cases for something like this. And in the past, there were entire applications that were built just to do this one thing. So this next one blew my mind a little bit. You're able to make a 3D render based on images that you create. So it does say there's four hidden steps here, and basically what that means is they created each view of this 3D render, and then they had the model put them all together and create a 3D render output. So they have OpenAI spinning here, and they also made the seal spinning as well. The next thing I want to touch on is audio. So This example, they're showing how you can put a logo created by ChatGPT on something, an object like a coin, right? Which is awesome. But the part that I really took away from this is at the end, they said, play the sound of the coin clanging on metal. And then it outputs a sound effect. So creating things like sound effects that you want for videos or anything else, right? You're able to just do this within the model. And in addition to that, you can upload any audio you want. So think of a meeting. You can upload the entire thing into here and ask it questions, have it summarize the meeting, take notes. In this example, yeah, they uploaded an entire 45-minute lecture and had the model summarize the entire lecture. And on this portion of their website, they go through the comparisons to their own models and other models in text, audio, ASR, audio translation, the M3 exam, and vision understanding. And it really does lead the way in all of these. Of course, this is on OpenAI's website, so take it with a grain of salt, but it'll be interesting to see how it does perform out there on all these tasks. Sam Altman also posted a couple of comparisons on Twitter with some different charts. So the overall ELO score, you can see that I'm also a good GPT-2 chatbot, leads the way by far. This was just a nickname they were using for GPT-4o. And then he also mentioned that in coding, it does far better than before, which is interesting because on the website, the comparison says, you know, the real jumps are in audio and vision, but it looks like based on these numbers, coding is greatly improved as well. So I'm excited to see what the outcomes of that are. What is the cost? So the amazing thing about GPT-4o is that it's completely free. The plus users are gonna get 5 times the amount of message limits. So if you're using it a lot, you know, it's recommended to get the plus version, but anybody can go out and try GPT-4o for free. They're doing a slow rollout. So GPT-4o should be out there on the mobile app and the web, but it does not have the entire feature set yet. The audio and video features are coming soon. The last added benefit with the new model is that it's much cheaper. Hopefully we'll be able to get more out of it for less. To wrap things up, while we're not quite at Jarvis level capability, we are getting really close. And I'm so excited for the entire feature set to come out. Overall, it just seems so intuitive with the audio and visual capabilities coming with the model. And like I said before, I can think of so many use cases for this, and I'll have follow-up videos going over those specifically. I can't wait to see what you all come up with as well. Thank you so much for watching, and stay tuned for more.